Good morning, friends. I'm Dr. Yogesh Sarode of Jivan Vikas Mahavidyalay Deogram. I heartily welcome you all in this session. Today, we will learn about the great personalities prescribed to BA Part 1, same one syllabus by Nagpur University. And the personalities are Ramchandra and Lakshman Rao Kirloskar. So friends, you are, or perhaps might be very well acquainted with the Kirloskar company, and the main behind this are Lakshman Rao and Ramchandra Kirloskar. Friends, though Ramchandra Kirloskar started the activity, but Lakshman Rao has a lion's share in it. So we'll see. Both the personalities. Lakshman Rao Kashinath Kirloskar was born on 20th June 1869 and took his last breath on 26th September 1956. He was an Indian businessman. He is the founder of the Kirloskar Group. He was born in Gurlasaur, a village in Belgaum district of the erstwhile Bombay Presidency. Lakshman Rao was a Maharashtrian Brahmin, and his father Kashinath Pant was a Vedant Pandit. Therefore, the society also expected Lakshman Rao to follow the footsteps of his father. However, he broke away from the traditions and entered the field of engineering and technology. Lakshman Rao was fond of two things, mechanical objects and painting. Against his father's wish and with financial support from his eldest brother Ramu Anna, Lakshman Rao joined JJ School of Art in Bombay in 1885, but unfortunately he had to quit after 2 years as he was found to be partially color blind. So he gave up painting but continued to study mechanical drawing at the institute. This skill came handy and led him to a position of assistant teacher of mechanical drawing at Victoria Jubilee Technical Institute on a salary, a small salary of rupees 45 per month that time. Sometime in early 1890s, Lakshman Rao started bicycle dealership. He would buy bicycles in Bombay and send them to his brother Ramu Anna in Belgaum, where he would sell them for a cycle of rupees 700 to 1000, Ramu Anna would also charge rupees 15 for teaching how to ride. His first venture, a small bicycle repair shop at Belgaum, was worth mentioning. The road on which he started the shop is today named as Kirloskar Road. See, the same term still we find today. Strongly believing that agricultural implements must fit the milieu they are used in, he manufactured iron plugs, the first Kirloskar product. He established a small unit in the former Aurangabad state of production of chap cutters and manufacture of iron plugs. In the early days, Kirloskar had to meet with opposition from farmers who believed that iron plows were poison to the land and make it useless. This was the charge against their company. Superstitious farmers were extremely hard to convince, and Lakshman Rao Kirloskar took 2 years to sell his first iron plow. लक्ष्मण राव किर्लोस्कर कुड नॉट फाइंड ए सुटेबल प्लेस फॉर हिज वर्कशॉप. हेल्प केम फ्रॉम द रूलर ऑफ औंध हु ऑफर्ड हिम ए प्लेस एंड अरेंजिंग लोन ऑफ 17,000 इंडियन रुपीज. सी दैट वॉज द बिगिनिंग. इन 1910 लक्ष्मण राव स्टार्टेड हिज फैक्ट्री इन एन एरिड वेस्ट लैंड बाय द साइड ऑफ अ रिनाउंड रेलवे स्टेशन कुंदाल रोड. द फैक्ट्री इज नाउ नोन एज फेमस किर्लोस्कर इंडस्ट्रीज एंड द स्टेशन एज किर्लोस्कर वाड़ी. सो लक्ष्मण राव किर्लोस्कर वॉज नॉट ओनली एन इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट बट ऑल्सो ए ग्रेट सोशल रिफॉर्मर. वेन ब्लाइंड ऑर्थोडॉक्सी वॉज रैम्पंट इन रूरल एरिया ही एडवोकेटेड द रिमूवल ऑफ अनटचेबिलिटी. ही बैंड अनटचेबिलिटी इन द टाउनशिप दैट ही हैड एस्टैब्लिश्ड एट किर्लोस्कर वाड़ी विच इज इन सांगली डिस्ट्रिक्ट नाउ. ही बिलीव्ड इन सोशल रिफॉर्म एंड ट्रिस्टेड इन गुडनेस ऑफ मैन. He employed ex-convicts at night watchman. He had read about industrial townships in Europe and America, where the owners of industries had built communities, colonies for the employees. His dream was to build his own industry and community for the employees. He realized this dream with Kirloskar Wadi, a place where he started the Kirloskar Brothers Limited factory in 1910. Lakshman Rao was married to Radha Bai and had 5 children with her. Son Shantanu Rao, Raja Ram, Prabhakar, Ravindra and a daughter. Departments of Post, Union Government of India issued a postal stamp for Lakshman Rao Kirloskar on 20th June 1969, marking 100 years of his birth anniversary. So, this was the preliminary of Kirloskar Brothers. To more detail, Kirloskar Brothers Limited was founded in 1880 by Ramchandra and Lakshman Rao Kirloskar basically. Before that, it was a trading company in Belgaum, India, and it was run by Ramchandra Kirloskar, elder brother. Because Lakshman Rao was in teaching job that time at Victoria Jubilee Technical Institute, Bombay. Because British teachers were promoted, ignoring his claim, he resigned. He reunited with his brother. And both they changed the focus of their trading from selling to manufacturing. They started manufacturing of bicycle pumps and set up a shop for its sale. See, the attitude now changed. 14 years after it was set up, Kirloskar Brothers Limited came out with a hand-powered chop cutter. In 1905, they produced their next product, an iron plow. Initially, the farmers did not give it enough response. They were comfortable with the wooden plow that they were traditionally using. But later, they realized that iron plow was more reliable than the wooden one. And as the farmers were beginning to appreciate iron plow, the Belgaum municipality ordered the Kirloskar brothers to vacate the premises. See the problems along the run. Baiyasaheb Pant, Pratinidhi, King of Aund in Maharashtra, offered them land and loan to continue their venture. The brothers relocated. And it was the beginning of setting up of Kirloskar Wadi, a factory that would expand into township. So in a true sense then, the factory was again established in 1910. Now, as I have mentioned earlier, it was founded in 1818, but re-established once again in 1910, as it is now the second oldest township in India. With importance of balance between work and community for success, Kirloskar Wadi was built near a railway station. The township now has schools, colleges, libraries, hospitals, and other basic community facilities, and its own PIN code. It means it has its own recognition. During World War I, the supply of iron was stopped and basic production was also affected. This time, the Maharaj of Solapur sold his cannons to Kirloskars. These cannons were melted into iron, which was used into making iron clothes. In 1940, they became the first Indian company to manufacture a lathe machine. With the beginning of Second World War, the Britishers wanted them to manufacture weapons. Kirloskar were not comfortable with it and instead offered to manufacture tools that can potentially be used as a weapon. During this time, Shantanu Rao, who was the son of Lakshman Rao, involved in company's affairs. He had a Bachelor of Science degree in mechanical engineering. Many of his decisions were taken with an aim to launch Kirloskar Brothers Limited and India into global market. So he established Kirloskar Electric Company and Kirloskar Oil Engines Limited. After the independence, the company started manufacturing imported diesel engines also. In 1958, the company started exploring, exporting also. In 1969, the company set up its factory in Kuala Lumpur. The manufacturing of hand pumps started with other expansions at Kirloskar Wadi. In 1973, Europe became the major market for Kirloskar Brothers Limited. This led to Kirloskar Empire enjoying growth rate of 32,000% from 1950 to 1991. See, the first expansion. In 1983, Sanjay Kirloskar, means grandson of Shantanu Rao Kirloskar, shifted his focus of the company from valve and pump manufacturing to an engineering, procurement and construction contractor. Now, this has made the company the world's largest pump manufacturers. It has its own it has its presence in over 80 countries. The company also secures world's largest irrigation project, Narmada project, implemented by Gujarat government. From the humble beginning of a cycle pump shop, Kirloskar Brothers created a business empire that stretched across the world. It ushered India and itself into global market. So friends, this is what is the creation of these two great personalities, Ramchandra and Lakshman Rao Kirloskar. Now, you always know, you always have heard that there is always someone behind the success or behind the success of a story. So, behind the Kirloskar Limited Company, these great stalwarts, their devotion, their sincerity, produced or created this feasibility of Kirloskar Wadi. Now, we will see some important aspects in their lives. So, as far as township is concerned, township was set up in Maharashtra by Kirloskar brother. Let us have a review of Kirloskar Wadi. Kirloskar brothers shifted to Maharashtra on the invitation of Balasaheb Pant Pratinidhi, the Raja of Aund, who offered him land to continue their venture. This place Kirloskar Wadi established in 1910, later grew into an ideal township. A remarkable foresight and a study of township in America and Europe helped Lakshman Rao to set up a well-planned township. Lakshman Rao believed that it was necessary to keep the staff of his industry happy to achieve enduring success. And with that in mind, Kirloskar Wadi was built near the railway station so that it would be easy for the people to communicate, to commute, to travel. This 100 years old and also the second oldest township has all the basic facilities that a community requires. This scenic green township has its own pin code. This is important. So this was about the township Kirloskar Wadi that was set up by Kirloskar brothers. Now, if you focus on the personality of Lakshman Rao, we find Lakshman Rao had all the qualities of a businessman. He had skill and expertise in technology. He understood the pulse of the market and therefore was fiercely competitive in his approach. He had a great foresight and vision which helped him to develop Kirloskar Wadi into ideal township. He understood the importance of striking balance between work and community. And therefore, he built Kirloskar Wadi near the railway station for the convenience of his industry stop. Lakshman Rao knew that his stop would be happy if all the basic amenities like healthcare and education are provided today in the township. Thus, we see that Lakshman Rao, with all his above listed qualities, had a lion's share in the success of Kirloskar brothers. Now, if we comment on the impact of First World War on Kirloskar Brothers Limited and how they resolved this situation, we think that after the Kirloskar Brothers established Kirloskar Wadi, the first major setback they faced was during the First World War. They faced an acute shortage of the supply of iron ore. Ore means a raw form of iron material. The future seemed bleak for the company. But the Maharaja of Solapur came to their aid. They helped him. He helped him. The Maharaja sold his cannons to Kirloskar Brothers Limited and that were melted in the plant to make iron flows. So First World War posed a challenge to the Kirloskar brothers. But their good contacts and innovation, sincerity, their commitment helped them sail through it successfully. Same was the case with Second World War. See the impact of Second World War on Kirloskar Brothers Limited and how they resolved the situation, how they came out from this situation. With the advent of the Second World War, the war posed another threat to the expanding business of Kirloskar Brothers. The ruling British insisted that the company should manufacture weapons for them. But Kirloskar brothers were uncomfortable with such a proposition. The Kirloskar brothers gave a logical option to the Britishers. They offered to manufacture tools which would potentially be used as weapons. The rationale beyond this suggestion was that the demand for the weapons would die down after the war, but the demand for manufacturing tools would increase. This is important. In this way, they would not incur loss. Thus, the Kirloskar brothers were able to face the second crisis with foresight and courage. Now, as far as the lessons of Kirloskar brothers is concerned, see what we learn from their success. There are many inspiring lessons to learn from the success of Kirloskar brothers. To start with, we should dream about big visionary projects. The adversity should not deter us from our path to success. We should learn to convert adversities into opportunities, like the Kirloskar brothers, just like whatever Prime Minister Modi ji did. Considering the COVID-19 situation, what we had not means we were in trouble. We had a shortage of many such things. We found that and we started production of it. So it was opportunity for us. When they were asked to vacate from Belgaum and during both the world wars, we should observe with pride that innovated without getting depressed and emerged with flying colors. All the big businessmen in India should lean that, not only lean, but should learn also that the Kirloskar brothers had not been established as just a company to derive profit, but the brothers kept the profit margin low and spent their money on social welfare projects. So from the story of Kirloskar brothers, we learn that for a businessman, it is necessary that he should think globally, incorporate constant research, and generate good will through community development. Means, instead of profit motive, one should first think about the society, and this is what is the message that we get from the from these two personalities. So friends, I tried my best to focus on these two personalities, Ramchandra Kirloskar and Lakshman Rao Kirloskar. I hope you will definitely understand the life of these two personalities. So we'll stop here. Thank you. Good day.